My name is Dr. Fashina Abiola. I'm your lecturer for the course Introduction to Early Childhood Education. The course code is ECE111. Now, let's start with the introduction. What do we mean by early childhood education? Early childhood education is the education that serves as foundation to other levels of education. It is the bedrock, and it's very important because it's at this stage that the development of the child is known. That is, the child develops mentally, physically, socially, and everything. Now, this study session or this course will give you an insight to what we mean by early childhood education, the different types of early childhood education, and so on. Now, let's all start with the learning outcomes. The learning outcomes for this study section is number one. At the end of this study session, you should be able to define the early childhood education, list the objectives of early childhood education, explain the types of early childhood education, and then differentiate between the various types of early childhood education. Now, let us take them one by one. Concepts of early childhood education. Early childhood education is the education given in an educational setting for children ages 3 and 5, between the ages of 3 and 5, that is prior to their entry to primary education. It prepares the child for future and for the formal schooling. It encompasses the physical, cognitive, emotional, and social developments of the child. That is the overall, all-round developments of the child. Now, let us look at the objectives. What are the objectives of this early childhood education? According to the National Policy of Education, 2004, we have about 8 objectives of the early childhood or pre-primary education. It's also known as pre-primary education. We have number one, effect a smooth transition from the home to the school. That is the first point of contact of the children. When the children leave their parents, the next one before the school is the middle way, is the intermediary. So it prepares the school, it prepares the children for the primary education. That is why it's for ages between the age of 3 and 5. You know, primary school is 6 years old. So when a child is around 3 years old, the child can start the early childhood education. Now, it also gives room for care and supervision. A lot of times, the parents are at work. So it is the children will be taken to primary school, pre-primary school, for the care and support that they need for security and protection. Then it conquers social norms. The children are able to learn different types of habits, good habits, especially toileting, everything like that. Teach good habits, and then the rudiments of letters is also taken into consideration. Letters, colors, numbers. This is the stage where the children learn all these things. Now, types of early childhood education. We have about 4 types. We have the number one, the daycare. We have the daycare. We have the nursery education. We have the kindergarten, and then finally we have the special schools. Let me take them one by one. Let's start with the daycare. What do we mean by daycare? Daycare means care, as the word says, care for small children. Day, during the day. That is children between the ages of 3 and 4. Between the ages of 0 and 3 years, they are being taken care of in the day, during the daytime, when the parents are at work. That's why they call them daycare. It's not a formal education. It's not like school, but, you know, it's a complementary to the home. It supports the... So they provide care and protection. They train young children in forming regular habits. Daycare centers are all over the place. For instance, before the introduction of pre-primary education, we have been doing all these things unknowingly. We have the Yorubas that they call it jealousy. The Igbos call it otakara and so on. This during unknowingly we have been practicing even before the introduction of early childhood education. It has been in existence. So now we have nursery. Now when the child reached the age of 3 now, it now transfers to the nursery school. This is where the child is being taught the self-esteem. The child will know how to improve in self-esteem, the language, the study habits. This like a formal education of children between the ages of 3 and 5 is bridge the gap between the home and the formal education. Now, it's also a source of mental and physical and social development of the child. So, then the last one is the kindergarten. What do you mean? The kindergarten means guardian, as the name implies. It's a German language, guardian of children. That is, children are in sort of guardian. The proprietor of this thing is the Montessori, Maria Montessori. The intention was that children will develop on their own. They will use a lot of toys and they will have guardian. So it will foster their self-understanding through play activities with greater freedom. So they are able to run. And this one is between 4 and 6 years old. This is the last year we have KG1, KG2 in some schools. They call it kindergarten 1, 2, and 3 and so on. Then the last one that is not is the special schools. These ones are the exceptional children. What we mean by that is the children that are, maybe they are like genius. They have those with, they perform beyond the expectation. They put them in special schools or exceptional school. And we also have the handicapped children too. They are those that have learning disabilities are considered in this special school. Now, let us look at summary. At the end of this lecture, I think you have been able to identify the meaning and the definition of early childhood education, the objectives of the early childhood education. Like I said, early childhood education or pre-primary education is the same thing. We call it early childhood or pre-primary education. The types of early childhood education, the daycare, the nursery school, nursery education, the kindergarten, and the special exceptional schools. Thank you.